This video presents the paper entitled "Modeling of Viscoelastic Environments for Humanoid-Robot Motion Control, Accepted for Publication in IEEE Robotics and Automation Letters." When the contact between a robot and its surrounding environment is stiff, controllers based on the rigid contact work reasonably. However, when the compliance of the environment increases, it is pivotal to design contact models that take into account contact stiffness and damping, which can then be incorporated in feedback controllers. In this paper, we present a model of compliant contacts for time-critical humanoid-robot motion control. The proposed model considers the environment as a continuum of spring damper systems, which allows us to compute the equivalent contact force and torques that the environment exerts on the robot. The main contributions of the paper are a new contact model that characterizes the stiffness and the damping properties of a viscoelastic material that exerts forces and torques on a rigid surface in contact with it. A whole body controller that allows a humanoid robot to walk on a viscoelastic floor, which is modeled using the proposed compliant contact model. The robot controller estimates the model parameters online, so there is no prior knowledge of the contact parameters. A validation of the approach on the simulated torque control humanoid robot ICAB. A humanoid robot is often described as a floating base system. The configuration of the system consists on the joint values and the pose of a frame rigidly attached to the robot, with respect to the inertial frame. The dynamics of the floating base system can be described by the Euler-Poincaré equation, where M represents the mass matrix, H contains the Coriolis, the centrifugal and the gravitational terms, J is the contact Jacobian, while tau and F are the joint torques and the contact wrenches. Consider a rigid body that makes a contact with a viscoelastic surface, and assume that the environment is isotropic and there exists a well-defined contact domain. It is possible then to define a continuous pure force distribution for each point of the contact domain that depends linearly on the point position x and its velocity x dot. Here we indicate with k and b the spring and damper constants. Once the distribution is well defined, then the equivalent contact wrench can be computed by integrating it on the contact domain. As a result, rotational spring and dampers are not required to model the interaction between the robot and the environment. The proposed controller architecture consists of two main blocks: the whole body controller and the contact parameter estimator. The whole body controller aims to track the kinematics and dynamics quantities, considering the robot and the compliant contact models. The main goal of the contact parameters estimator is to implement an observer that identifies the contact parameters used by the controller to stabilize the system. The whole body controller computes the desired joint torques using the robot joint dynamics, where the robot acceleration is set to the desired quantity and the contact wrenches are estimated. The desired generalized robot acceleration is chosen to track the centroidal momentum trajectory, the torso and the root link orientation, and the feet pose, while considering the contact model and the feasibility of the contact wrenches. The control problem is formulated using the stack of task approach. The control objective is achieved by framing the problem as a constrained optimization problem, where the low priority tasks are embedded in the cost function, while the high priority tasks are treated as constraints. The presented optimal control problem is based on the perfect knowledge of the contact parameters. In a simulated environment, the value of the parameters is perfectly known. However, in the real scenario, an estimation algorithm is required to compute the parameters. The contact model is linear with respect to the contact parameters. So, we aim to estimate them such that the least square criterion is minimized. We compare the performances of the proposed controller, here called TSD compliant, and the state-of-the-art controller, called TSD rigid, in the case of different contact parameters. Both controllers seem to show good tracking performances. The TSD rigid introduces faster variation on the measured contact branches. This contributes to overall higher vibrations on the robot. One reason for this behavior is that the TSD rigid assumes full control of the desired contact branches. This assumption is in general valid in the case of stiff contacts, but it doesn't hold if the environment is compliant. If the compliance of the environment increases, the TSD compliant is still able to guarantee good tracking performances. On the other hand, the TSD rigid requires high variations of the robot accelerations, and after a few seconds it fails in finding a feasible solution. Here, we analyze the robustness capabilities of the TSD compliant controller in the case of non-parametric uncertainty in the contact model. We model the uncertainty by using a Gaussian noise with zero mean at a given standard deviation. Despite the uncertainty on the model, the controller can guarantee good tracking performances. We finally analyzed the contact parameters estimator performances in the case of an anisotropic environment. We modeled the contact parameters as a piecewise function of the forward walking direction, assuming that all points of the contact surface have the same contact parameters. To cope with the contact parameters discontinuities, we reset the state covariance in the recursively square algorithm each time a foot impacts the ground. The observed parameters converge to the ground truth in less than a second. The experiment shows that during the transient phases, the controller achieves good overall performances.